All right, solving and checking these equations. So on the first one, we could subtract 8x from both sides. We're going to put the variables on one side, constants on the other. And at the same time, since the x's are going to be on the left side, I'm going to add 5 to both sides. You could take 2 steps to do that, or 1 step. So 7x minus 8x is negative 1x, or negative x. And these cancel, negative 5 plus 5. Over here, these cancel, 8x minus 8x, so I have 9 plus 5, or 14. Well, this says negative x is 14, so we can multiply or divide both sides by negative 1, so that x equals negative 14. All right, now let's check it. All right, so to check it, you're going to put a negative 14 in for x. So we have 7 times negative 14 minus 5, and do the order of operations. So I have to multiply 7 times negative 14 is negative 98 minus 5, or negative 103. All right, and on the right side, we're going to also put in negative 14. 8 times negative 14, which is negative 112, plus 9, and that's negative 103. And you compare. Both sides of the equation are negative 103 when you replace x with negative 14, so that means this is the correct solution right over here. Okay, let's go on to B. All right, so what we could do here is add 3 to both sides to begin, so that we could isolate the x term, 2x over here. 2x equals 15, and now divide both sides by the coefficient of x, which is 2, to get x equals 15 halves. Now, if you would like to write that as 7.5 or 7.5, that's also fine. All right, let's go over here and check it. So we're going to plug in 15 halves for x. All right, so we can cancel the 2's, and that gives you 15 minus 3, which is 12 on the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, there is no variable to plug in, so you just bring down the number, and you have the same thing. So x equals 15 halves is the correct solution because I got the same number on both sides. Okay, next one. All right, we need to do the distributive property on both sides. So we've got 8y plus 16 equals 6y plus 8. So I'm distributing the 8 over here and distributing the 2 over here. And now I have to get the variables on one side, so I'm going to go ahead and subtract 6y to both sides, from both sides. And since I'm going to have my variables on the left, I'm also going to subtract 16 from the left-hand side, so that I just have 2y on this side of the equation, on the left side. So 2y equals negative 8. And now we want to divide by the coefficient of x, which is 2. So y is negative 4. All right, so now we have to check it. Now when you have to check it in the original. So no distributive property, you are going to just plug in negative 4 for y and do order of operations. Negative 4 plus 2. So inside parentheses, that's negative 2. And 8 times negative 2 is negative 16. All right, same thing on the left. We're going to plug in negative 4. 3 times negative 4 plus 4. So I need to do order of operation inside the parentheses, so that's negative 12 plus 4, and still adding inside the parentheses, I have 2 times negative 8, which is negative 16. You compare the left side and the right side, and same answer. Okay, let's go to D. There's more than one way to begin this problem. You can either multiply both sides by 2, or you could subtract 13 first. I'm going to go ahead and subtract 13 first. So subtracting 13 from both sides means I'm going to have my variable left on the left-hand side, x over 2, and negative 22 plus negative 13 is negative 35. All right, now that says x divided by 2. I just want to know what x is, so I need to multiply both sides by 2 so that I just find out what x is. Or you could think of that as multiplying by the least common denominator. So we have x equals negative 70. All right, let's check it. So we have to put a negative 70 in for x. So that's negative 70 over 2 plus 13. All right, doing order of operation, negative 70 divided by 2 is negative 35 plus 13. And negative 35 plus 13 is negative 22. The left side, there's nothing to plug in for x, so you just bring down the number. You see we have the same number on both sides, so we do know that this is the correct solution. All right, now this one has lots of fractions, right? We have x over 5 minus 1 half equals x over 6. When you have fractions, it's easiest to multiply by the least common denominator. And the least common denominator of 5, 2, and 6 is 30. That's the smallest number that all of those go into. So what we're going to do is multiply both sides of the equation by 30. So I have 30 times x over 5 minus 30 times 1 half equals 30 times x over 6. You're multiplying both sides of the equation, so you're really distributing that 30 everywhere on both sides of the equation to all terms. And now we should have some canceling going on here. That's going to give you a 6. Over here I'll give you a 15. And over here that'll give you a 5. So I have 6x minus 15 equals 5x. All right. So that's the way to eliminate all those fractions. Becomes an easier problem. So now I need to get the variables on one side, constants on the other. So I'm going to go ahead and subtract 5x from both sides so that we have the variable on the left. And at the same time, I'm going to go ahead and add 15 to both sides so that I have the constants on the right. So that'll give me x equals 15. All right, let's check it. Now when you check it, sorry, but you're stuck with all these fractions. So we have 15 over 5. I'm sorry, it should be 15 over 5. Minus 1 half. And is that the same thing as 15 over 6? Change color to make it a little bit easier. Okay, so 15 over 5, 15 divided by 5 is 3 minus 1 half. 3 minus 1 half is 2 and a half, or 5 halves. You could write it either way. And 15 divided by 6, you could reduce by dividing top and bottom by 3, which is also 5 halves. So this reduces to 5 halves, and so I could see I have the same number on both sides. So that means this is the correct answer. It checks.